I'm gonna brush your head. 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 I'm gonna brush your head.
Absolutely riveting rendition of the Star Spangled Banner by Haley. Great job, young lady.
Here we go, Sparstar Promotions.
Time to get back to work.
Proud to present the first time ever Sparstar MMA Flightweight WMMA title. This bout is sponsored in part by HQ Gym, downtown Los Angeles. Once again, our referee in charge of this bout, Mylon Ayer.
You gotta be down low, boss. Stay down.
And now, introducing to you first on my right, fighting out of the red corner, she is wearing black trunks. She is training out of Nubians MMA in South Central by way of Los Angeles. She weighed in 129 pounds. Her record, 2 wins, 2 losses, with 1 win coming by way of submission. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Jasmine Tap Out Queen Poche! Her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the blue corner. She is wearing a pink sarong. She is training out of Gooch Training Academy in Woodland Hills by way of Los Angeles. She weighed in 112 pounds. She brings to the cage an undefeated record, 2 wins, no losses, with both wins coming by way of submission. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Oneida Diaz.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Our referee, Mylon Ayers, to give final instructions.
Some final instructions from veteran referee Mylon Ayers.
Fight clean, fight hard, fight fair. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. Good. Turn to your corner.
All right, fans, here we go. The first time ever, Sparstar MMA Flightweight WMMA title bout.
All right, here we go, folks. Flyweight title bout. Jasmine Pouncey, Oneida Diaz.
Oneida Diaz the first to take the center of the cage.
Pouncey
switching
Superman
stance, lands a nice Superman. And a nice knee to the body of Diaz.
Diaz is looking to push this up against the cage, but Pouncey is not having it, throwing big knees. Trying to muscle her around, looking for that throw, loses it. Not sure what Pouncey's going for here, maybe an arm bar.
It looked like Diaz was trying for a little bit of an Uchimata throw there, and Pouncey countered, sending her backwards, and now she's in top position.
This is a strange position here. Pouncey has a headlock. But
Diaz reverses.
I'm sorry, Diaz has a headlock here, but without an underhook, he's going to try to step over to the mount now.
Oneida Diaz looking for a bulldog finish here. One hook in, second one enters.
Oh, she flattens her out. This is a bad spot for Pouncey.
Jasmine Pouncey eating hooks to the ears in a bad spot early on. And Oneida looks to wrap up the choke. Kevin, is that under the chin?
I can't see it from here. It doesn't look like it. She's off to the side now. Pouncey looks to be out of danger from the choke, but still not in a great position. Again, flattened out both hooks. This choke might be in. I can't see it.
Pouncey in serious trouble here.
It looks pretty deep. Pouncey is fighting off that hand, which is the right way to defend against the choke.
Refusing to allow her to gable grip to finish that choke, but Oneida Diaz has threaded that left hand underneath the chin of Jasmine Pouncey.
It's more or less on the mouth, but you can still finish there.
Might be a little bit of a crank here, Kevin.
It's more like just a face crush at this point, but you can still get a tap there.
10 seconds left. It looks like Pouncey's going to survive the frame.
Now it's creeping under the chin.
Excellent first round.
I like the back control.
Oneida Diaz.
Yeah, Diaz showed a Very nice back control. You see the way she sunk both hips and engaged her hips. I'm sorry, sunk both hooks and engaged her hips forward to flatten out Pouncey. Pouncey showed a lot of resilience by fighting off the choke and staying alive in the fight. But I can assure you she doesn't want to end up there again.
Now coming into the second round, if you're Oneida Diaz, do you look to do the same thing? Shoot a takedown early in the frame and keep control of this fight?
Yeah, you know, the way they got to the ground was a little strange, but I think once they got there, Diaz felt that she was at home. I think she'll look to get the fight back there again.
Tell me if you seen her. She always bring the racket like Venus and Serena. All white top, all white belt, and all white jeans, body looking
once
like
again,
milk.
This fight is no for a 115-pound title. My chick bad, a lot chick on the line here. My chick bad.
All right, round two, ready to kick off here. We'll see if Diaz tries to get the fight back to the ground. We'll see what Pouncey does to keep it on the feet.
Round two in front of an absolutely packed Hollywood Park Casino. Sparstar MMA underway for the 115-pound title. Jasmine Pouncey and Oneida Diaz in round two. First round was all Diaz on the ground. Pouncey looking to establish her stand-up here.
Nice front leg sidekick by Pouncey, trying to find range.
Nice right hand lands for Pouncey as well.
You see how Diaz gets desperate when she gets hit and runs in with both arms out forward? She did that last round and got lucky with the takedown. But you can eat a big shot when you run in like that.
Jasmine Pouncey showing a lot more comfort on her feet here. Some educated striking, finding their home. Oneida Diaz is in trouble here.
There's Diaz. She's looking for a plumb clinch when she reaches her arms out like that, and it was successful.
Reestablishes control by pushing Jasmine back up against the cage and sucking those hips in for a takedown.
Perfect transition through a 1-2-3-4, then changes levels to secure the takedown against the cage.
Diaz in position for Yvonne Flew, but she likes it go. Pouncey ties up the guard.
Nice job by Pouncey to regain close guard there. We'll see what she can do to keep the posture of Diaz broken down. Efficient for an arm lock, but no real control over the arm.
Some softening blows from Diaz find their spot.
Pouncey now looking for an ankle lock. I like this. She's reaping the leg, though. Mylon Ayers needs to step in, and he's going to reset here for the leg reap.
You can't do heel hooks, correct?
Well, there are no. I don't know what's going on here. Yeah, there are no heel hooks, and the way she tripped Diaz was with a leg reap, which is also illegal.
You're not allowed to torque the knee.
Correct, from the outside.
Front kick from Pouncey lands, but she falls briefly back to her feet. Diaz flirts with a head kick, but misses. Some lefts and rights from Diaz as Pouncey digs to the body. Nice right hand from Diaz again. Second round comes to a close. This one a lot tougher to score. How do you have this one, Kevin Widows?
That's a tough round to score. It's razor thin. You know, I mean, I think they both did good things on the feet. When Pouncey did end up on bottom, she did a good job of staying safe.
Now, if you're Jasmine Pouncey coming in, you possibly could be down two rounds to none. What do you do in this situation to reset the game?
I think she's got to keep it on the feet. She had some success with landing some strikes on the feet. You know, I think she just needs to land that one hard shot, get the fight where she wants it. Can't let Diaz push you up against the cage. We've seen what happens there. She's gotten taken down twice.
Potato chips might come in handy tonight. Everybody here in Hollywood Park having more fun than you and I, Kevin.
Exactly. I had the munchies for some reason. And I don't think it's anything I did.
Are we back in college?
Is this a Grateful Dead concert or an MMA fight?
Easy. Easy. Touchy subject. All right, round three underway. Jasmine Pouncey and Oneida Diaz for the 115-pound Sparstar title. Ooh, spinning back fist from Pouncey.
Almost
misses.
A spinning elbow. Diaz is going to, and she's going to change levels here. I look for her to change level. Maybe not. She had her in the spot. Nice front leg sidekick again from Pouncey.
Nice right hand hook, lead hook from Pouncey. Makes a thud on Diaz's head. But once again, Diaz is just controlling the grappling, bullying Jasmine up against the cage.
And there's that takedown again. Nice, this time lands with the underhook.
Once she connects the hips, there's really not much Pouncey can do. Diaz again in dominant position, landing some softening blows underneath the right left armpit of Pouncey. Pouncey doing her best to control posture as Mylon Ayers, referee extraordinaire, calls for action.
I like the way Diaz is being patient here with her guard pass, though. She's waiting for the right moment to either slide that right knee over to the mount position or bring it back to the left side for a knee slice pass. See how she's working it out?
Now, here's a technical question for you, Kevin. Your jiu-jitsu pedigree much higher than mine. She's working in the half guard now. Mm-hmm. What point do you abandon strikes to use your right hand to try to clear that leg so you can achieve mount? Or do you just stay in half guard and land the left hand?
You can do either or. You know, there are guys who like the control of half guard because you still have your opponent's hips pinned to the mat. What she did wrong here, though, was allowed Pouncey to get back to close guard, and now Ayers is going to stand him up.
Now, from a judge's perspective, landing blows in half guard or landing blows in side control, which one do you think score more?
Side control, for sure. It's a more dominant position, but, you know, you can finish a fight from top side control. I'm sorry, top half guard.
Pouncey and Diaz going at it. 10 seconds left. Neither lady giving an inch. We got ourselves a brawl.
Wow. Nothing left in the cage from both of these fighters. Put it all on the line. What a finish. And Renato Laranja is back from the dispensary. We're going to welcome him back to the booth.
One hell of a three-round fight. Oneida Diaz, Jasmine Pouncey. I got to tell you, the only clear winner of this fight is everybody who is watching.
I take it easy. You said the only clear winner?
Only clear winner.
Oh, sorry.
Clear.
Sorry, you know, I just put my headset and it was not working.
Unfortunately,
I was outside talking to some girl, but I didn't know there was some girls fighting in here.
You know, Kevin Widows alluded to that earlier. He was worried you got molested by a couple women.
You know what? He's not entirely wrong on this one.
All right, you guys take over. I got to go interview the winner.
Where's my other cerveza, boy?
We need a...
They're bumping the cheeks together.
Somebody send the waiter over for Renato. We need a Modelo.
Yeah.
They come for
Ashley Evan Smith over there looking all good with that outfit.
Did you say hi to her?
That chat show. Yeah, I said she's...
Did you bless her with a hello?
Well, she's you know, looking to my baby Browns and getting lost in them. She's
baby,
lucky
baby
I don't
Browns.
Have my long curly hair like I used to have. She would have get fucking lost in there too. I tell her take her panties off quick. It's like a lamb's wool, a baby lamb's wool. The curls. No product. Just water. Let it breathe. I control. California living till I am old. We want to be on to peak on the charts so the peons can be gone and pee on their hearts. She ain't the coupe. She ain't the neon because she aren't the BS before we can start on. Nobody will her. I go will her. Let them know I'm priority. Order me. Hennessy for the homies. OG killer. Call it Jason. Boy, he's boy. He own his job. Boy, he sure be ever the marks. On they mark. Pretty girls playing tiger marks. Let them nail the pipe exhaust. Let them reveal how much it costs for this life. Controlling my vice. No way.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, once again, let's give both fighters a big round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the scorecards. We have our decision. Judges ringside, Dr. Nelson Hamilton and Jackie Denkin both score the bout 29-28, while Larry Landless scores the bout 30-27 in favor of our winner by unanimous decision. She is the first time ever SparStar WMMA flyweight champion. She is also still undefeated, Oneida Diaz! Ladies and gentlemen, once again, from the theclinchreport.com, Jonathan King.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, before I get to your winner, Oneida Diaz, let's give it up for her opponent, Jasmine Pouncey, man. Win or lose, Jasmine, you're one of my favorite fighters to watch. Great job tonight. All right, Oneida, get over here. You're turning the spotlight, young lady. You got some new jewelry around your waist. Why don't you let everybody hear? How's it feel? Let me say it to you for the first time. The new 115-pound Spar Star champion. How do those words sound?
It feels amazing. All the hard work, it's worth it. All the hard work is worth it.
Now let's get into the fight here. Jasmine Pouncey, real tough opponent. You had your way with her in the first round.
Why'd they let people
Things
wear shoes in
that
far?
A turn in the second round. She came out guns blazing. She landed a few shots. You stayed
They might as well let the fighters have shoes.
Going. Was your whole idea to bring this fight to the ground? Did you think
you're inviting bacteria
into that? Got her to the ground?
Yeah, I do believe I have a dominant, you know, ground game. But, you know, also always got to work, stand up, you know. So wherever it goes, got to take it there to win. So whatever it takes.
Now 3-0 and the reigning Spar Star 115-pound champion. When can we expect you back in this cage, young lady? Now, at this point in time, like I say to every fighter fights alone, but no fighter comes into this cage without a team behind them.
Yeah, we heard
that
one.
I'm sure you got a lot of teammates, sparring partners.
How many times I got to hear
that? I don't know if
them.
Any of them are here tonight. If you are, who do you got to thank for this one?
Is that Johnny Hendricks to the left
my
of us?
Family.
Or that's a falafel salesman?
My boyfriend's family. My
shish kebab.
All of your hard work has paid off. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the inaugural Spar Star 115-pound champion, the beast, Oneida Diaz. Great job.
How you doing, my brother? I'm better than ever. You're smart. You're loyal.
There you have it, folks. Oneida Diaz.
DJ Khaled with his fat self.
Oneida Diaz coming away with the championship.
And you look, you see how disinterested that girl is to DJ Khaled when he's giving that money and shit. And he says, say my name.